Hi, I'm Trent Helton.
I'm here with
Caden Pasilli.
So what are you doing for Labor Day?
That's a good question. Probably playing pool volleyball.
Nice, nice. Now, do you know the actual definition of Labor Day?
No. Actually, yes, I do, but I'd like to hear yours.
Well, I don't know.
Hi, I'm Ashley Pedrino, and I'm here with
Anthony Mora.
And what are you doing this Labor Day?
Honestly, I didn't know Labor Day was happening.
Do you know why we celebrate Labor Day?
Yes. Because the people really got to do some hard work, and we want to support them, we want to help them. So, you know, you get what I'm saying.
Very inspirational. I really do appreciate it.
Hey, Maddie, do you have a job?
I do.
Where do you work?
I work at Forest Home.
And where is that?
In the mountains.
What do you do?
I make milkshakes.
Take a day off from work and relax, catch up on your rest, and just take it easy.
And do you currently have a job right now?
Yes, I do. At one time, I had 4 jobs at the same time.
So, Cameron, what do you think Labor Day is?
Labor Day is like the day that we celebrate like the American contribution to let's cut this.
Are you employed?
Yes.
And what might that job entail?
Telling 14-year-olds what to do professionally.
Child nutrition technician.
There it is.
We live to feed you kids. That's our job. And we get here at 5:30 in the morning, and we start making all this food for everyone.
Now, are you familiar with the term Labor Day?
I have heard of it, yes.
Mm-hmm. Do you know anything about what that might be about?
We don't have to come to school on Monday, right?
Well, that was actually Thunderstruck's doing, but...
thanks, guys.
In your own words, what does Labor Day mean to you as a working class citizen?
That we should have a break and take the day off.
And why is that?
Because we're not appreciated enough.
Enough said. Labor Day is actually to celebrate the working class.
That's wonderful. So you guys are all celebrating me by not being here at school.
Just for you.
Just don't come to my house and we'll be all right.
No promises.
In sports, the girls' volleyball team defeated La Quinta last Tuesday. Now let's take you there.
Sending in the mirror. What's that icy thing hanging around me?
Carly, the players of the game against La Quinta. How does it feel to get this win?
It feels pretty good. I feel like we worked pretty hard. Our discipline and our effort definitely showed in this game. I feel like we're just going to keep going higher and higher and higher as we go along this season.
And Carly, what do you think we did right?
Our serving was super aggressive on the service line today, and our defense was balls out. We got tons of touches on stuff that we didn't expect, and we got a bunch of good kicks.
Now a shout out to all the homies who finessed a dub at Grand Terrace last Friday. Now here's some highlights from that game. We traveled to Grand Terrace last Friday, and the cheer squad set the tone with this phenomenal sign: "Your school, your field, our game," and that turned out to be true. We started off with a 20-yard pass from Keel McChesney to Austin Bollinger, and look at the saucy footwork to keep the 2 feet in bounds. Here's the play of the game. Grand Terrace was about to score when Harris Heaton saved the day by intercepting the ball in the end zone and cruising down 100 yards for a T-Bird touchdown. Keel wasn't done scoring yet as he threw a dart to Adam Vasquez. Touchdown number 88. And that made our cheerleaders even happier. To add insult to injury, Austin Bollinger said, "Give me another touchdown pass, this time a 35-yarder from Keel McChesney." To put the cap on the game, Mikey number 8 powers it in on the goal line. And that clinches a 34-13 win on the road at Grand Terrace for the Thunderbirds.
So we just beat Grand Terrace, and these are the players of the game, Bollinger and Heaton. Heaton here got a 100-yard interception. How did that feel?
You know, it felt great, man. It was my first ever time scoring on a varsity football team, so it was just like a pure moment of happiness.
Yeah, it was really impressive. Bollinger over here got 2 touchdowns with some fancy footwork at the end. How did that end up?
I wasn't sure if I was in bounds. I just wanted to make sure, so I got the touchdown for it too.
Both of you did really good job, and our team did overall as well. Back to you.
Thanks, Jace, and thanks for being our honorary member of Thunderstruck for all these years as our sideline reporter. Be sure you support our Thunderbird football team as they return home tonight to face a tough opponent in Villa Park. Happy Labor Day weekend.